just got a big black widow for my yard. This black widow is 1 inch long and has a leg span of 1 inch, approximately. And we're gonna feed it a 2-inch mantis. Caught this in my yard. This is cup and paper. Well, and black widow, I have a lot of black widows in my yard. Black widows are very venomous, or else I would have caught it by hand, and if you know me, you know I catch stuff by hand. Now, I'm carrying a camera and a black widow, a huge one, to my praying mantis jar. Black widows are very venomous, and this seems like a huge one that I found is patrolling. Is that a web? Not a web. Which is very unusual to me, since every black widow I see is on a web. And this one's a pretty big one. So I think it'll be dangerous. Let's just wait for it to go in the cup. It hasn't gone in the cup yet. Maybe a hit will help. On the cup. Now this is my praying mantis. Let me show you my praying mantis. Okay, so I put the paper on top of the cup. Keep drink the black widow face. And this is my praying mantis. It's about 2.5 inches long or something like that, or 2 inches. Maybe 2.5 inches. This is his jar. And now we're gonna see what happens if I add the black widow into its jar. It seems a little interested in escaping, which I'm not sure is happening. Ooh, so let's, I think he likes to climb to the top. I'm trying to hit the black widow down again. That process is finished. Yep. And it's climbing right towards the praying mantis. Not yet, but it's climbing right towards the praying mantis. It seems like the praying mantis did not notice. Put a spider right there. There it is. I think it's spinning away. you're going to have to shake the cage to get the mantis' attention. But, to move it. Black Widow. Got to make the Black Widow move. Catch a spray out of it. Make it meet the bucket in. I want to slow the video if the gun method catches it. Pray. Who's going in deep to the Black Widow part? Nothing can escape the praying mantis' arms. It has spikes on its arms to catch its prey. And a mandible, some praying mantises have mandibles that can pierce human skin. Otherwise, the slender neck praying mantis cannot. And by the way, the slender neck praying mantis. You can tell a slender neck praying mantis from the markings under its eyes. And the spiders tear it apart. Its markings right there. See its marking on its eye? And I can tell from the slender neck praying mantis from the others. Nope, looks like he's about finished. And the fact that it caught this Black Widow with such ease is because it has the element of surprise. All praying mantises do have this. They pretend like a leaf, a branch, or maybe a flower sometimes. So that's it for today. So bye, and don't forget to subscribe.